got prescription.
Right in front of us, not in front of the
computer. I heartily welcome you to this session, and believe that by the time our colleagues in the media leave here today, a lot of questions will have been answered. The Ministry of Economic Planning and Budget is a very, very critical ministry in whatever happens in Lagos State. Yesterday, the Ministry of Finance were here. They told us how they spend the money. That was what we came to yesterday. But the Ministry of Economic Planning decides how the money is to be spent. There was one day the Honorable Commissioner went on holidays. I didn't know it was on holiday. I think Honorable said, "Where is I said, "He has been kidnapped." Went to the news, he has been kidnapped. Ah, somebody said, "How do we get money to Benin?" I said, "There is no VOC. No VOC to Benin." He said, "The governor would." I said, "The governor would have to ask him first to provide that VOC if we must first be in. If we don't have VOC, and that's who he is." See, there's something about this ministry that, you hold on to money like this. So, when it gets to their turn, if anything happens to them, they will ask you to go and bring VOC. So when it happens to them, we will provide that VOC. But again, when you look at what has happened to Lagos, to thank this very ministry, this is the best governed state in Nigeria. Look at it. And I say that with all conviction, that if the crop of officers we have in the Ministry of Economic Planning and Budget were to run the national affairs in Nigeria, definitely the economy of Nigeria will be far better than it is today. That is the extent of my respect for this ministry. And when my MC was also talking about our platform, that we are live streaming this event, we are on Twitter, we are on the social media, we are on YouTube. I have to also thank the Honorable Commissioner for Economic Planning and Budget because he gave us all the support. He supported us because he also is a man, is a very current person that believes that the new direction of information management is tilting very fast towards the new media. Thank you very much. And without necessarily taking up most of your time, let me introduce that man that has followed in the path, a tradition established since 1999 to ensure that Lagos enjoys its very, very solid economic base, one that attracts international ratings, one that attracts national upload. Wherever we are today, we go there because we have tested and committed members led by the Honorable Commissioner for Economic Planning and Budget, Mr. Benjamin Ifeanyi Akabwe. Let me gladly welcome you there to come and present your hand.
The special advisor, His Excellency, on information and strategy, special advisor, His Excellency, Economic Planning and Budget, Permanent Secretary, Ministry of Economic Planning and Budget, directors in the ministries of information, Economic Planning and Budget, other senior officials of government, present, gentlemen of the press. Good morning.
Good morning.
come again before you to render the account of stewardship in the Ministry of Economic Planning and Budget. This is not just another of our annual press briefings, but it's more significant because it will encapsulate our efforts to support the transformation of the economy of our dear state of Lagos in the last 8 years. Today, I am proud to say that we have lived up to the pledge that our team will do our best as the principal think tank of government to further grow the economy of the state. I am elated to say that the economy of our state has continued to grow steadily at a rate of over 10% per annum. And just to be clear about this, you have heard the growth rate of the economy averaging 6 to 7% in the last several years. For the whole of Nigeria to be growing at that rate, the Lagos economy, which is the nerve center of the nation's economy, clearly needs to grow and above the average rate for the country. So there's no confusion between the rate that we're quoting for Lagos and the national growth rate. Our ministry's vision is to be the primary agency of government that facilitates efficient and effective mobilization, planning, allocation, and utilization of resources for the socioeconomic transformation of the state. We have tried to achieve this by articulating dynamic socioeconomic policies while ensuring prudent and equitable resource management in the state. Our key ministerial responsibilities are as follows. We serve as the principal economic think tank for the state, coordination of economic policies and programs, preparation and implementation of the state's long and medium-term development plans, and as well as the annual budgets, monitoring and evaluation of state government's projects and programs, coordination of development partnership, production and dissemination of official statistical data. And our ministerial goals are the promotion of private sector-led growth in the state, generation and utilization of relevant and reliable data for planning, deepening and broadening of state revenue base and development partnership sources, effective expenditure control and project monitoring, promotion of enhanced partnership for development. Our core values are adherence to due process and, in a way, I'm sure you recall the famous due process office federal government years back. That just represents one of the things that we promote in the Ministry of Economic Planning and Budget. Our values include dynamism, commitment, fairness, professionalism, team spirit, hard work, loyalty, prudence, and integrity. We are, of course, organized along different directorates and departments. And I will now proceed to just speak more elaborately about our activities under each of those directorates and departments. Economic planning. The ministry, as the principal socioeconomic research arm of the Lagos State Government, is saddled with the responsibility of developing clear planning parameters to achieve the goals of government as espoused in the various high-level policy documents of the state, which have now been harmonized into the State Development Plan 2012 to 2025. We also serve as a custodian of all planning matters in the state with the following specific functions: management of the Economic Intelligence Unit, coordination of medium-term expenditure framework and medium-term sectoral strategies, development and monitoring of long-term development plans and such other planning documents in the state, coordinating implementation of Millennium Development Goals Conditional Grant Scheme in collaboration with the Office of the Senior Special Assistant to the President on MDGs. A total sum of ₦6,899,896,013 was expended on 657 conditional grant scheme projects covering health, environment, education, water, and sanitation sectors in the state. And speaking about spend from during the life of this administration from 2007, today. The federal government contributed ₦3,700,346,884 out of this amount. The state provided counterpart funding of ₦2,539,448,006, while the local governments contributed ₹520 million. Collaboration and implementation of development partners programs for Lagos State. Liaison with National Planning Commission and other related agencies, especially on development planning and accessing support from development partners. Oversighting planning units in MDAs. Serving as secretariat to the Lagos Economic Summit Group. A total of 4 summits were held in the life of this administration in 2008, 2010, 2012, and 2014, from which 116 resolutions and recommendations were generated. 106 of those resolutions have been resolved, while 10 are outstanding. Through our various units, which include Economic Intelligence Unit, Policy Planning Unit, Strategy Planning Unit, and Project Support Unit, we have achieved the underlisted in the last 1 year. The Lagos State Government adopted the Medium-Term Sector Strategy, MTSS, and the Ministry was responsible for its implementation as part of the budgetary tool in preparing the 2015 budget. To ensure issue-free implementation, the Strategy Planning Unit of the Ministry had, prior to adoption, trained, produced, and reviewed 36 MDAs, medium-term sectoral strategies. Midwife, the effective takeoff of the program-based budgeting, PBD, through the medium-term sectoral strategy for 2015 budget, which replaced the traditional budgeting format for the first time in the state. This template ensures that all MDA's activities are classified into specific programs for the purpose of resource allocation and accountability. The PBD is structured in such a way that it fast-tracks decision-making and feeds into the preparation of subsequent years' budgets. We implemented budget profiling, which identifies agencies' expenditure on a monthly, quarterly, or one-off basis for the purpose of effective cash management at the State Treasury Office. We compiled and consolidated the high-level policy documents of the state into a single state development plan document, which provides an overarching long-term strategic plan to guide all development towards attainment of the vision for Lagos State. The public presentation of the Lagos State Development Plan 2012 to 2025 was performed by His Excellency Mr. Babatunde Rajafashola, SAN, Governor of Lagos State, on the 16th of December 2014. Prepared the 2015 to 2017 medium-term budget framework document, which informed the 2015 annual budget preparation. The Economic Planning Department also conducted some researches on the economic outlook for Lagos State, diversification of the Lagos State economy, and funding of tertiary education in Lagos State. And these informed stakeholders about government activities and also culminated in the production of policy briefs and working papers. We also then published the Lagos Policy Review, Volume 1, Number 1, as well as Volume 2, Number 1. Budget. Let me begin by just overviewing the 2014 budget performance. Gentlemen of the press, you will agree with me that the fulcrum of this administration's success has been the efficient and effective mobilization, planning, allocation, and utilization of resources for socioeconomic transformation of the state. Our budgeting approach is now program-based, as highlighted earlier, which simply means that it links planned expenditures to clearly determine results. It lays emphasis on outcomes, service delivery, and on and results rather than inputs, activities, and outputs. This will greatly improve service delivery as it will sharpen the focus of MDAs on the results of their activities. The year 2014 budget of 489.69 billion naira was signed into law by His Excellency Governor Babatunde Rajafashola, SAN, on Monday, the 13th of January 2014, and was revised once in the course of implementation. It was slightly reordered on the 20th of August 2014, with capital expenditure review downwards from 255.025 billion to 247.825 billion naira, and recurrent expenditure increased to 241.865 billion from 234.665 billion without any change in the budget size. The review was due to the following exigencies. One, the Ebola outbreak. Two, heightened security challenges. And three, the reversal of LASU fee increases. The year 2014 budget recorded an overall performance of 83% by the end of that year. Other activities executed by the budget directory during the period under review included second quarter half year 2014 budget performance appraisal, which was held on 22nd of July 2014, at which time the budget performed at 106%. The budget consultative forum held on the 30th of July 2014, to obtain the inputs of the general public into the year 2015 budget. The EXCO legislative rally on the 2015 budget was held on the 9th to 10th of October 2014. The presentation of the third quarter 2014 budget appraisal on the 10th of October 2014, at which time the budget is performing at 84%. The presentation of the 2015 draft budget proposal of 489.69 billion to the Lagos State House of Assembly by His Excellency the Governor on the 24th of November 2014. The fourth quarter 2014 slash full year 2014 budget appraisal, which was presented on the 18th of February 2015, and which showed that the fourth quarter performed at 77%, thus resulting in an overall full year performance of 83%, as earlier highlighted. The publication and distribution of the Citizen's Guide on the year 2015 budget. Let me now comment briefly on the 2015 budget. The year 2015 budget of 489.69 billion, you will note, same size as the 2014 budget, comprised 247.713 billion capital and 241.977 billion recurrent expenditure. It was prepared in line with the policy direction of the state government to meet the yearnings and aspirations of the good people of Lagos State. Like it was with the 2014 budget, the 2015 budget is a zero deficit budget and is focused on four key thematic sectors of the economy, namely power, agriculture, agro-ally, transportation, and housing, the path. This is the pathway towards improving the economic fortune and creating job opportunities in the state without prejudice to the other functions of government. The capital to recurrent ratio is 51-49 for 2015 as against 52-48 in 2014. The budget was passed into law and assented to His Excellency Mr. Babatunde Rage Fashola SAM on the 11th of January 2015. The sectoral allocation of the 2015 budget are as follows. General public service 22.2%, public order and safety 3.4%, economic affairs 13.3%, economic environmental protection 7.2%, housing and community amenities 10.1%, health 9.1%, recreation, culture and religion 0.6%, education 16.8%, social protection 0.3%. These sectoral highlights of the 2015 budget are contained in our Citizens Guide publication, copies of which will be distributed to you all today. The first quarter 2015 budget performance showed an overall 59% performance, as against 67% performance recorded in the same period in 2014. The distractions of the protracted election season clearly adversely impacted performance of the budget, in addition to the declining federal revenue allocations. The aggregate budgetary expenditure in the last 8 years is ₦2,749,498,000,000. The average budget performance over the period stands at 79%, i.e. from the inception of this administration to date. before applause. Let me repeat that again. That this administration has achieved an average budget performance of 79% out the 8 years that it has been in power. The total revenue during this period has been an aggregate of 2,433,349,000,000 naira, representing 89% of the total expenditure. So 89% of our total actual expenditure in the lifespan of this administration has been funded by revenues of the state. And I need to repeat these numbers because especially during the hiring season, people were banding all kinds of figures about how much the state government has spent. Red figures, 4.something trillion naira. Actual expenditure of this government, today, has been 2,749,498,000,000. And out of this, 2,433,349,000,000 have been revenues, accounting for 89%. So when you hear also about the state living mostly on loans, that cannot be. What that translates to is that only 11% of our expenditure, the last 8 years have been funded by debt. Of course, not all of the revenue is internally generated. Internally generated revenues accounted for, are funded on the average 59% of the budgetary expenditure over the last 8 years. The average sectoral allocation of the budget from 2008 to 2015 for general public service 23.7%, public order and safety 3.12%, economic affairs 31.58%, environmental protection 8.56%, housing and community amenities 9.17%, health 7.66%, recreation, culture and religion 1.52%, education 14.09%, social protection 0.6%. You will notice here that the bulk of the expenditure has the largest single sector in terms of budgetary allocation has been the economic affairs section. And this is economic affairs sector, which has responsibility for delivering most of the infrastructure. Because of the huge infrastructure deficit, we have had to allocate a larger chunk of our budget to the economic affairs sector. But in the years ahead, as we walk down the infrastructure deficit, a greater proportion of budgetary resources is expected to be allocated to the human capital sectors, the social sectors, principally health and education. State statistical data. The government of Lagos State relies very much on data in taking informed decisions regarding resource mobilization and allocation, as well as measurement of the impact of its policies, programs, and projects. The Lagos Bureau of Statistics is responsible for generating high quality, relevant, and reliable data for our planning purposes. The ministry conducted the 2014 edition of the Lagos Welfare and Service Delivery Survey, commonly referred to as Lagos Household Survey. The survey was designed to gather information on a range of topics from people living in Lagos State at household level, with a view to determining the impact of some of the state government projects and programs on Lagosians, as well as strengthening planning mechanism in the state. It showed that the state has continued to make progress generally in improving the people's quality of life. The study covered the 20 local government areas and 37 local council development areas in the state. Comprehensive information was obtained on varied sectors of the economy, such as demographic characteristics of the households, education, health, infrastructure, income and expenditure, economic activities, housing conditions, access to social amenities, asset ownership, violence, crime, and safety, as well as other related matters on the welfare of the people of the state. The household survey provides policymakers, planners, program managers, and researchers with a set of indicators for monitoring welfare and poverty status of the inhabitants of the state along the local government divide, as well as appraising the social and economic situation in the state. Generally, it provides relevant data required to monitor growth and development. The ministry, in collaboration with TNS RMS consultants, carried out surveys in the following areas. Water sector, to establish the current sources of water in Lagos households generally and explore in closer details the current pricing situation as it relates to water in the state. Lagos homes, to evaluate how well the Lagos residents understand the Lagos Home Scheme and gauge overall acceptance of the scheme. Citizens' needs and expectations, to know the needs and expectations of citizens in sectors such as health, education, roads, and housing. Performance tracker, to gauge public perception of the performance of the present administration, concerns for continuity, awareness of the political parties, and the willingness of the people to vote. LBS also assisted the Ministry of Commerce to design the questionnaire and trade enumerators for the Entreda, which is a survey to identify and register enterprises in Lagos State. It also created the Eco Info Database Administration. The application is a database system for monitoring human development. It is a powerful tool for organizing, storing, and presenting data in a uniform way, which allows data to be easily and quickly shared across nations, government departments, agencies, and other development organizations. In summary, a total of 47 studies were conducted, 9 comprising household survey, 1 poverty survey, 1 impact of free health, of free textbook, and 1 computation of state GDP survey were conducted by the Lagos Bureau of Statistics. 12 were conducted in collaboration with different MDAs like Office of Transformation, Transportation, Education, and so on. 24 surveys were conducted with consultants. And two with development partners. We joined the rest of the world in celebrating the World Population Day on Friday, the 11th of July, 2014, to increase people's awareness on various population issues, such as the importance of family planning, gender equality, poverty, maternal health, and human rights, and to brainstorm on issues affecting population growth and profile solutions, monitoring and evaluation. In order to ensure that the public get value for the expended funds, the ministry monitors the execution of programs and projects to ensure that they meet specification. Payment for projects and procurements valued 500,000 naira and above require certification by the Monitoring and Evaluation Department, MED, of this ministry. To effectively carry out this responsibility, the state government improved the capacity of the Monitoring and Evaluation Department officers through the World Bank approved tour to India and Brazil to learn innovative M&E methods and institutional arrangements for sale. The result of this capacity building is the processing of prepayment certificates within 72 hours and a drastic reduction in the return of payment certificates. A core evaluation team was set up to periodically evaluate government's projects and programs to ensure that the expected outcomes are achieved. Also, we coordinated performance management reports in MDAs statewide and produced performance management and assessment reports on government programs. The ministry issued prepayment certificates in the sum of 39,675,634,415.44 only, relating to 1,246 projects in the past 1 year. In the last 8 years, this ministry, through the Monitoring and Evaluation Department, has certified 8,961 projects and programs valued at 1,132,269,742 is the value of a total of 8,961 projects and programs that have been certified by this ministry in the last 8 years. Coordination of Development Partnership. The Development Partnership Department, DPD, of this ministry is responsible for the facilitation and coordination of development partnership program activities in the state. It liaises with both local and international development like donor agencies on behalf of the state in order to facilitate sustainable development partnerships. Let me use this opportunity to again express gratitude to our development partners for the various projects and programs they have supported the state on during the past year, as highlighted below. The UK Department for International Development, UK DFID. The UK DFID one of our development partners has intervened through different state-level programs, including State Partnership for Accountability, Responsiveness, and Capability, SPARC, Education Sector Support Program in Nigeria, ESPIN, State Accountability and Voice Initiative, SAVI, Partnership for Transformation of the Health System, PATH 2, Growth and Employment in State 3, which specifically focused on land and tax reforms as the GEMS 3, the Growth and Employment in State 4, which focused on wholesale and retail market as the GEMS 4, Justice for All, J4A, Enhancing Nigerian Responsiveness to HIV/AIDS, ENR, Developing Effective Private Education in Nigeria, DEEPEN. Notice that each of these programs are very fancy acronyms. Under the DFID GEMS 3 intervention, the Development Partnership Department attended the World Bank GEMS 3 presentation on doing business in Nigeria 2014 report in Abuja. The report recognized improvements recorded by the state on four regulatory areas: starting a business, dealing with construction permits, registering property, and enforcing contracts. The report also provided information on good practices, compared gender in business, and showed example of how states had learned from each other. United Nations organizations. United Nations Children's Fund, UNICEF, is a long-standing partner of the state. UNICEF is currently running a new country program cycle, which has two broad areas of cooperation with Lagos State, namely transforming social service delivery, strengthening governance accountability, including reduction of the risk of crisis. In 2014, UNICEF supported people-oriented activities and programs of Lagos State government in a number of ways, including strengthening the institutional and human capacities of some state universal basic education board / colleges of education, sensitization meeting for healthcare workers from 10 high burden prevention of mother to child transmission of HIV in local government areas, clinical mentoring for pediatric HIV/AIDS care